The assumption, you know, we have, well, I have to really go back. There are two assumptions that we have here. Is that the parameters are almost slope varying over space. This is what I mean. That if really the demand changes dramatically from one location to its neighborhood, then this would not work very well. That's actually the case. The second is that the system has to be large scale. We're assuming infinite homogeneous in the neighborhood. If this system, this S is small to begin with, probably that assumption would not be good because the boundary would have an effect on it. So we need large scale, we need slow varying, these two assumptions. So in that case, you know, that's probably the case that I would say would make the problem not, the approach not very, very good. I don't know if I addressed your question. This is the assumption.
Yeah, I'm just thinking about in terms of a highway a lot of time. So for example, if I build a, from the location point of view, warehouse, say, if I come up with a constraint, say, well, I wanted to close the highway.
Yeah.
So in a way that the choice of those specific locations are already bound with those major highways, et cetera. So in a way it's not a continuum plane. In that case,
yes,
it's a confined space, constrained
right.
space in a way.
That's where the boundary effect will come in. So in this case, we really assume that it's large scale and continuous. So that in that case, probably, I don't know, I never tried, but it probably would work, probably not. But then, thanks for the question. Yes?
In the model, you say that transportation cost is the main cost that's incurred if a customer has to switch facilities.
Right.
Are there situations where there may be some other additional costs that I'm not expecting?